Right, Parvati. Warning. Safety failures detected. High likelihood of moderate to severe structural damage. Warning. Redirecting power is an irreversible procedure. Are you sure you want to continue? Is that because I turned that stuff on? Continue? It didn't say that before, did it? Redirect power to Edgewater. Botanical laboratory power regulator is now safe to remove. Edgewater Saltuna cannery power regulator now operating at optimal efficiency. Permanent power failure detected in botanical laboratory. Additional structure damage detected. Notice, blatant disregard for space restorer's property has been logged. Please report yourself to the designated supervisor for an immediate reprimand. Comes now the power. Is this place gonna fall apart? Pieces choice are now reverting, is that what it says? Now that the power is off, you should have an easier time convincing the deserters to move back. They don't want to kill me. With all the mechanicals and the plant out of commission, there's no need to modify their behavior. Oh, sad. I didn't know. These people are not going to be happy with me. Look at my reputation. Revering. They're both revering. Not going to be revering for long, are they? Don't all try to kill me. I don't want to defend myself and kill you. And I also do not want to be killed. Is she up here? She moved. They look like they have power. Oh, they're all around this. They're all huddled around the fire. Sealed. So this is the, yeah. Is she in here? I want to go back and get that mag pick. Looks like they might all be huddled around here.
One of us want to go see what happened? I don't know how much longer.
I know. I'm trying to think.
Everybody keeps staring at me. It's not my fault the power's dead. What's on your mind?
Keep your wits about you, friend.
Keep your wits about you, friend. I don't know how much longer we'll last.
I don't know how much longer we'll last.
I don't know how much longer we'll last without power.
Don't see why Thomas can't just get the generator up and running. Something I can help you with?
Marauders can't see us in the dark. Wild canids, on the other hand.
I don't know how much longer we'll last without power.
Keep your wits about you, friend.
Keep your wits about you, friend.
She's over there. Well, if she's over there, let me grab this mag pick.
Okay, keep him quiet.
Yeah, thought I was a friend to these people, huh? How sad. Where is it? Things are like gold. I should try to remember to buy one if I ever see one in a merchant's inventory. Sealed. Okay, we can only... They seal all but one of the doors. That doesn't make a lot of sense. Okay, so the power regulator's here as well. Hi.
That's the thing about growing old. Your eyes start to fail. Elsewise, I would have seen you for the snake that you are. Chop you into pieces and roasted you on a spit.
I don't want you to eat me.
This is all you're doing. Cutting off my power, killing off my garden. Without refrigeration, my food will spoil and my flock will starve. I want to ask you this in private. Away from the eyes of my flock, so they do not see me lose my temper. Tell me, why did you do it?
It's really two, but I'm gonna tell her Reed needs his people back.
You want my flock wasting their lives in that cannery? Fine. Go and talk to them. Go talk to Grace and Thomas. Look them in the eye and tell them their life here is over, and the only thing left to do is go back to Edgewater. This is now your responsibility. And you tell Reed Thompson that I will never return to Edgewater. I would rather die among my flowers than live under his management.
I'm willing to deal with Reed for you. I feel really bad.
You offering to cross Reed off, huh? This some sort of twisted reparation for what you've done?
I didn't mean that.
Or you just looking for a chance to sow some chaos? Kill Reed if you must, or talk him into leaving if you can. He and I are not sharing the same four walls together.
I didn't mean get rid of him. Alright. So I have to talk to these people. Convince the deserters to return. Now that their power is off, you should have an easier time convincing the deserters to move back. Adelaide refused to move back. You may have more luck convincing some of the other deserters. In particular, she suggested you speak to Grace or Thomas, as the others will listen to them. Adelaide refuses to return to Edgewater unless Reed is out of the picture. Her people will follow her back to town if she returns. Maybe I should just take him out of the picture. I mean, he's not a black and white character, although he may seem it.
Sorry. I'm just trying to figure out what to do, is all.
You're not going to survive without power, Thomas. I'm afraid it's time to go back to Edgewater.
I've been thinking about going back. I'm not much use to anybody here. I get sick thinking about working at the cannery. I can't do that again.
So don't work at the cannery. You wanted to be an engineer.
You know something? I think you're right. The town could use another engineer, and I'm on my way to becoming one. I could do a lot of good in Edgewater. Maybe even keep a garage of my own with a little workbench and my very own toolbox. It's just... Adeline's never gonna forgive me. Not in 100 years. I go crawling back to my old life in Edgewater, and I'm as good as dead to her.
He could probably work in Parvati's place, because I'd rather she come with me. If she wants to. Good as dead to her. Why is that?
Adelaide hates Edgewater. Hates everything Edgewater stands for. Hates what that town does to people. What it did to her. We're the nearest she's got to kin. We go back to Edgewater, we may as well have stuck a knife in her heart.
You know what? Stay put. I'm gonna try to talk Reed into stepping down.
You know where to find me.
Maybe I can talk him into it.
Keep your wits about you, friend.
Keep your wits about you, friend.
Which one is which?
Standing around the campfire is nice and all, until one of us starts singing.
Huh?
Something I can help you with?
Okay, I can't convince him. Yeah, Grace.
I'm not in the lightest of humors right now.
There's nothing left for you here, Grace. It's time to go back to Edgewater.
The matter's been weighing on me. Zoe came back, but I couldn't keep her from slipping out in the first place. Who's to say I could keep marauders from slipping in? I don't see us lasting more than a couple of weeks out here. I'm loath to admit it. We're gonna have to make our peace with Thompson and hope he takes us back. Listen, we go back to Reed, hat in hand, begging for our old jobs back. Well, Adelaide's not gonna forgive us. She never talked to us again.
Thomas told me the same thing.
Edgewater's not just a town to Adelaide. It's a symbol of everything that's wrong with this colony. A big, heartless machine of metal and gears grinding workers down to dust. We're the closest thing Adelaide's got to a family. We go back to Edgewater, she's gonna feel betrayed.
Well, don't do anything hasty. I'm gonna try to talk Reed into stepping down.
Sure. Suit yourself. I'll be here.
Maybe we can talk him into stepping down.
Look at that. The snakes come back.
I'm not sure where this goes. Hold on a second. I don't inadvertently want to choose something that I don't know what I'm choosing. Snakes come back.
Look at that. The snakes come back.
Reed isn't going to just leave his post. I'll need some help convincing him.
Tell Reed that I can make his people healthy again. I can end their plague.
Really?
Start a new garden right in the cannery. 3 square meals for every man and woman in Edgewater. Tell him how I've made the veil bloom again. The soil has whispered its secrets to me, and I alone know how to breathe life back into the earth. The secret is human corpses. I've been grinding them up in my fertilizer for years. Marauder, worker, don't matter much to me. The human body is rich with nutrients.
Right, okay. Human corpses or fertilizer. Makes sense. It's gonna smell really bad, though. What happens when you run out of corpses?
Edgewater Cemetery's got corpses aplenty. Enough for a generation's worth of crops.
Dead end.
Look at that.
I don't have any option to say anything else. Okay. After speaking with Thomas and Grace, you discovered they want to move back to Edgewater. Adelaide refused to move back. Yeah. Should be able to salvage their power regulator now. Can I just take this thing? Did you see anything different?
Look at that. This.
You have found a power regulator. Return to your ship. Not yet. We have to help these people. A general purpose power regulator used in electrical transformers required to repair the unreliable. Hopefully it is more reliable than the unreliable. Alright, let's return. Talk him into this. What if she has anything to say? Hold on a second. They're still revering. They don't seem to care that I shut off their power. Weird. I deserve a big bonus and a promotion.
I think you did the rightest thing you could sending the power back to Edgewater. A lot of people would have suffered otherwise. People I care for, even if they don't care much for me.
This place has the coolest music, just gotta say. Cannery, see if I can talk him into something.
Sometimes I wonder what I'm doing.
I mean, my persuasion isn't that great. Probably gonna be tricky, isn't it?
This is a fine day, friend. Power flows through our town like a cool stream of water. I trust Adelaide's people have seen their way to reason. So, when can I expect them back at their posts?
Yeah, I thought that power plant was gonna fall apart. It was kind of warning me of that, but it was fine. I thought I was gonna run out of there. I spoke to Adelaide. She won't come back, so long as you're here.
Then we are at an impasse. Stewardship over this town has been entrusted to me by Spacer's choice. I am not perfect. I have made my share of mistakes. But I have done my best for this town.
Your town's a mess, Reed.
I have been holding this town together with both hands. You can't just expect me to leave. I am a Spacer's Choice man. My father was a Spacer's Choice man.
Attack.
Edgewater may not look like much to some buttoned-up freelancer, but it is my home.
Well, Adelaide's people aren't getting sick with plague.
I don't believe you. Plague's a reality of life. Best treatment is a good work ethic.
This town doesn't eat anything but salt tuna. Of course you're going to get sick.
You are disparaging our parent company, and it is not appreciated. We are a Spacer's Choice salt tuna cannery. We eat salt tuna here, and only salt tuna.
That's it? Just salt tuna? Every single day?
The salt tuna's been a mite bland ever since Adelaide left. And we don't get as much salt tuna these days, so we've had to improvise to meet quotas. We've added wood chips, some mushrooms, bit of sand. Tossed some canid bits in our processor once. It all tastes like salt tuna in the end.
That can't be healthy.
Health is a state of mind, friend.
Oh, God.
Afflictions in one's body are reflections of afflictions in one's work ethic and attitude. Now listen, I do not know what pretty rhetoric Adelaide has fed you, but plagues are a simple fact of life.
Adelaide's found a way to grow food. She'll come back if you step down.
You'll excuse me for being skeptical. How exactly is Adelaide growing crops in barren soil?
She's been using human corpses in her fertilizer.
Adelaide has been using dead bodies in her fertilizer? That's... come to think of it, that's a stroke of brilliance.
What
a
remarkably
efficient solution. Recycling Spacer's Choice property long after its date of expiration. I was wondering about those missing bodies in Silas's cemetery.
This town needs Adelaide. She won't come back, so long as you're here.
So, Adelaide wants me gone. Trade my life for the life of the town. You understand what she's doing. If I leave town, I am as good as dead. If I stay, Edgewater will die of attrition. Adelaide has discovered some secret cure for the plague. And she is holding my town ransom.
I can't make that decision for you, Reed.
No, I don't expect you to do any such thing. Edgewater is my own responsibility. And you have done quite enough for me already. If Adelaide's found a way to feed her people and cure the plague, then she deserves this office more than I do. I won't stand in her way.
Wow.
My life here is ended. Give me a little time to settle my affairs. I'm sure Adelaide will be glad to see the back of me.
What are your plans?
A couple months ago, I might have put in for a transfer. It's a big colony. Spacer's Choice has other towns. Now, I couldn't show my face in any of them.
Why not?
No such thing as an honorable resignation. Suppose I could find a place outside the walls, or put in for early retirement.
I want to be nice to him, but I don't want to talk him out of it, if that's possible. This can't be easy for you.
I have always tried to do right by my town. It has never been easy.
He does have to do this. Take care.
I already told you I'm leaving. Just give me a little while to collect my thoughts.
Wow. I didn't think I'd be able to do that.
Something you need?
That's pretty amazing. Reed has been removed from Edgewater. Return to Adelaide and tell her the news. Will do. Oh. I picked the wrong place. Sorry, guys. Titus Andriticus. Blood and Revenge are hammering in his head. A new original masterpiece from the director of Agent Khan. And stuff. Got good news. Maybe you'll stop calling me a snake. The slithering snake of doom.
Look at that. The snake's come back.
The snake did good. I talked Reed into leaving. Come back to Edgewater.
I never thought I'd see the day that Reed Thompson abandoned his post. Suppose we all have a breaking point.
True.
Suppose it's time our flock made our way back to Edgewater. We must tend to what remains of the town and carry on with our lives as best we may.
That's a lot of XP.
You're vexing to me, you know? Injuring us with one hand, helping us with the other.
Yeah, well.
Here. I'm giving you something to leave us be.
The board
it's reputation. A ransom. You understand? Not a reward.
Elliot's watch? Okay, so the board decreased. I guess that's the board of Spacer's choice. Because we removed his guy. And now my reputation is increased from revered to I don't know what, I'm a goddess? I don't know. I made a mess of things. Guess I'm just trying to set it right.
This don't put us on even footing, you understand. But it is a start.
Sorry.
I might turn that old cannery into a garden. Got ourselves a whole cemetery bursting with bodies. I need some time to gather my personals. Long walk back to Edgewater. Got a considerable burden to carry.
Hold on, guys. Okay, that was a sneeze. Yay!
That was a good thing you did, Captain. Helping to bring the deserters and Edgewater folks back together. I hope you rest well on that.
I do, Parvati. I do. And I've got my power converter, whatever the hell it's called. She's just gonna start walking over there.
Alright. Adelaide's okay.
Keep your wits about you, friend.
Standing around the campfire is nice and all, until one of us starts singing. Something I can help you with?
I'm not in the lightest of humors right now.
Well, I got good news. Adelaide's agreed to go back to Edgewater.
Didn't think she'd go back so long as Reed was still running the place. Something must have changed.
Yeah.
If Adelaide's going back to Edgewater, we'll follow her.
Something changed. He is deleted from the place. Where's, what's his name?
I'm glad Adelaide's coming back to town with us. With Reed gone, we're gonna need her leadership. What's on your mind?
So he knows that Reed's gone. I thought that was her standing there. Alright, let's head back. Let's see if we can find some changes to the place already. Hi.
I don't want any trouble.
Okay, never mind. No changes there yet.
What can I do for you? Go ahead.
Alright. I'm just gonna check the cantina and then the cannery itself. Probably nothing new here, though.
Town's been humming with power. Somebody must have been down in the old plant.
Okay, that's a new thing.
Go ahead.
Alright, never mind. Let's go to the cannery.
Sometimes I wonder what I'm doing.
I wonder if she says... I've been wondering actually what she says if we go... if she comes in here.
This is where the magic happens. Well, science. But it still happens.
True.
Where are we headed?
Alright. I figured she'd have a little line when she walk in there. Let's see if we'll find Adelaide here. And or Thompson gone. Oh, he's still here.
I already told you I'm leaving. Just give me a little while to...
All right, never mind. So before we leave, we have a couple other things to do around here. I'm sure we have more camps to discover. We have some caves, we have people we need to get that have warrants on them. We need to fill their bounties. So I have no idea where those people are. I guess that's going to involve some old-fashioned just walking around. Quest dependencies. Oh, that's right, I can level up now. I was just so excited I was successful in this. I forgot I leveled up. Get to 30 there. A little better defense. There we go. You have unlocked perfect blocks. When you time your block just as the enemy melee attack arrives, it staggers the enemy, opening them up to a ferocious attack or something like that. Okay. So before we head back to the ship, like I said, we have some other things to do, so we're just going to, like, explore around for a little while. And then we'll go back to the ship. We have warrants to figure out. So. Or to fulfill. So thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. Very excited that we were able to do this. Very happy it worked out pretty much for the best. I do feel a little bit about Thompson, though. Although he was an idiot. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.